Planet Rock. Backstage at Steelhouse 2018, I'm Ian Danter, delighted to say Mr. Dan Reed of the network has joined us. You've just come off stage.
Yeah, my wet knees proof.
Oh, look at that. Wet everything, because it was a bit damp out there.
Yeah, it was, but it stopped during the middle of the set, and it was good for most of it, actually, yeah.
And, as you just discovered, there was a rainbow
during
Rainbow Child.
Yeah, it was
you
good.
See, you know how to plan
maybe
these things.
There is a God.
Yeah, maybe so. Listen, the Dan Reed Network, I remember going to see you back in the day, making people dance, making rockers dance. Yeah. And the set you've just done there, you've just got people completely shaking
and
the shoulders.
Got all the rain gear on.
Yeah, the ponchos, you know, moving the... what an effect you still have on audiences. Don't, and just get them moving, man.
Oh, it's an honor to see that, to be honest, and to see the different generations, like little kids with their parents. And it's so cool.
The UK's been a really important place for you and for the network, hasn't it?
Absolutely. I think the very first show we did here was in London at the Marquee in 1987 or 88. And from that moment on, it just sprung out. Then we toured Bon Jovi in 89, the Stones in 90, and then just at the height of it, I quit. But had I not quit, I don't know where we'd be now. I might be dead. I'm a drug overdose or something.
But yeah. And
so
it's,
there's a positive side of quitting.
Absolutely. There is also the acoustic stuff you've been doing with Danny Vaughan, the tours you do with Danny, the stuff you do on your own. Mm. You know, you've always found a way to, you know, make the UK aware that you're around and you're important. You've got work, you've got things to say still.
I just like to write music, and the reason why I quit back in 93 was because I felt like the business was becoming about turning us into a product, you know, like a marketing tool. One of the reasons why I shaved my head right before the Stones tour was to kind of test the waters about like, is it about music or is it about fashion? You know, what is it about? And the more and more I felt like we were just like a piece of merchandise, the less I was interested in the music business. When I came back about 10 years ago, I just felt like this is time to, it's about melody, lyric, smiles, you know, intention. And it's not about selling stuff. It's really about just getting out and playing. If we can make a living at that day.
And 10 years on, you're happy with the way the system is and the way that
with the internet and everybody being on equal footing, no longer are wannabe musicians in high places and record companies running your career. It's we are doing it and we live and die by the work we put into it.
And speaking of records, there's one coming out pretty soon.
Origins. We've been doing these studio sessions, we call them, in Manchester, New York, Portland, Oregon, Stockholm, and now we're doing one in Berlin at David Bowie's old studio, Hansa Studio. And we record a new song and an old song, and we remake an old song and turn it different. And we have a live audience, about 100, 150 people.
Right.
And they get to sing background vocals, and we share a meal together, and then we do an unplugged concert at the end of the night with requests, and just involve the people that have been there for us since the beginning. And that's the record that's coming out in November, is those sessions. So.
And we should stress at this point that you're coming back not to do a proper UK tour around that time.
Yeah.
A big three-band bill, and it's going to be a party time.
I think so. Mason Hill from Glasgow and Hollow Star from England. It's going to be a really, really fun tour. Great new bands that are coming out.
How is it a bit playing festivals? And do you have to tailor your set much in terms of playing to a festival crowd that you know it's not partisan towards you?
I don't know. I think for us, we enjoy playing together so much on stage that it doesn't matter if there's 5 people or 5,000. For us, we're just like trying to connect with each other. And once in a while, we get out there and like, I love the festival stages where you can go, it has the, what do you call it, the tunnel?
Ego ramp.
Yeah, the ego ramp. ego ramp. Why do I love that? No, but it's fun to get out there and you feel like you're just immersed in the round a bit. And I really enjoy that. So I can say that I favor festivals over like 2,000 seat, you know, venues. But I really like 300 seat and 400 seat clubs. Those are fun.
Yeah, man. But, I mean, you're playing these wonderful songs that really, for me, in any way, stood the test of time. Songs like Rainbow Child and Make It Easy and Tiger in a Dress. I mean, there's lots of artists who bemoan the fact that they have to play the hits.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not satisfied creatively by doing that. I mean, what's your take on all of that?
Well, we played one new song in the set tonight, and we do maybe two. If we're doing a two-hour set, maybe three.
Yeah.
But for us, we always try to pay homage to the fact that our history is why we're here in the first place. And so I try to play the old songs as if I'm playing them for the very first time. Danny Vaughan has another interesting angle about that. He says when he's playing his old hits, And how he gets through it is he plays it like it's the last time he's ever going to play it. So we have different angles of looking at it. But for me, it's all about just pretending that it's the very first time you ever played this song, and I think about where I wrote it, why I wrote it, and then all of a sudden it feels fresh to me, and I'm not bored with singing it 100 times.
Well, I think it's fair to say, I mean, everyone out there will agree with me, you stormed it today at Steelhouse. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thanks for speaking to us. Dan Reed with us here, backstage at Steelhouse 2018. Planet Rock. Planet Rock.